everyone. My name is Larissa, and I'm a blue coat at Science North. You found me looking at my finger lasers. I found these in my kids' room. Actually, these are LEDs, and they're going to be perfect for me to explain to you all about light and color mixing. White light is a mixture of all the visible light that we can see. We get different colors by mixing the primary colors of light. And the primary colors of light are red, green, and blue. Here are a list of the materials that you will need if you want to follow along at home. It's all right if you don't have everything. You can just watch the video and watch the demonstrations and learn all about color mixing by watching what I'm doing on the screen. What colors do you see when you look at a rainbow? Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. A rainbow is formed when the white sunlight passes through a water droplet and it is bent or refracted. Light of different colors, different wavelengths, is bent at different angles, and we see all the colors of the rainbow. I'm going to show you how to make a rainbow your own. All you need is a bowl of water, a little mirror, and a flashlight. Or you can use some natural sunlight if you'd like. Follow me to my living room. We've got sunlight coming in through the windows. As you can see, the sunlight shining in the mirror goes through the water and makes a rainbow pattern. If I move the water, the light becomes white again. All the colors are mixing. You can also make a rainbow by shining light at a CD. Look how all the colors appear on the CD when light is shining on it. What are some other items that you can use to make rainbows in your home? You can use a prism. You could use a glass of water and a piece of paper shining through some sunlight. You can use diffraction grating. You can even use bubbles. If you have a paper tube that's lying around, you can use a paper tube and your CD, with permission from your parents, to make what's called a spectroscope. So you cut a 45 degree angle in your paper tube, you put your CD in there, and you cover the top with a little bit of foil, with just a little bit of a light, and you can use your spectroscope to figure out what kind of light is coming from the light that we see. Spectroscopes are usually used to figure out the chemical makeup of stars, but you can go around and look at all the lights in your home and see what kind of light your home lights are made out of. What are the primary colors of light? They're red, green, and blue. When you mix two of the primary colors of light together, you get the secondary colors of light. Red and blue equal magenta. Blue and green equal cyan. Green and red equal yellow. You might notice that the secondary colors of light seem similar to the primary colors of pigment. We've just substituted magenta for red and cyan for blue. Remember, our primary colors of paint are red, blue, and yellow. Have you ever looked closely at the screen of a tablet or a cell phone? I have a magnifying glass here. If you look close enough, you'll be able to see all the different pixels, and they have all the different colors. But really, they're just combinations of the three primary colors of light. If you take some water and spritz it on your screen, make sure you ask for permission first, the water droplet will magnify the pixels, and you'll be able to see all the different colors that make up the colors that we see. Finally, I'm going to show you how to make colored shadows. What color is your shadow normally? If you go outside in the sunlight and look at the ground, your shadow is usually dark or black. But if you use colored lights, your shadows will actually appear different colors. What you're going to need is a small box that you can line with white If you don't have a box, you could darken a room and use a white wall. You'll also need your three different colors of LED lights and a flashlight, or if you have the white LED, you can use that as well. You can use a pencil to make a shadow, or you can use an object that can stand up on its own. First things first, we'll shine our white light on our object and take a look at what kind of shadow it makes. As I said before, it makes a dark or black shadow. The next thing, we'll shine all three of our colored LEDs on our object. Take a look at the colors of the shadows that you see. You should see three different colors of shadows, and they're actually the same color as the complementary or secondary colors of light. As we systematically turn off each light and have two lights projecting on our object, we'll see how the colors of the shadows change. You can experiment with this at home. They use this technique in theater productions and music concerts to make really interesting effects. And that's it for our video. I hope you enjoyed yourself and that you learned a little bit about light and color mixing. And we'll see you next time at Science at Home.